finance, a la shmup. What is the advanced decline ratio? All right, people, it's just a percentage, just like all its brethren or fellow ratios. All right, but what does that percentage tell us? What's that ratio all about? Well, basically, it looks at a given index, like the 500 stocks of the cleverly named S&P 500, or the 30 stocks of the Dow, or the 1,200-ish stocks of the Schmegegi Small Cap Index, yeah. Well, it then just adds up which stocks went up that day, like, last Tuesday, 312 stocks in the S&P 500 went up, and 185 stocks went down, and the rest just sat there not moving. You know, like this guy, Congressman, our finest, best and brightest. So why does this advanced decline number even matter? Like, why do we track it? Well, what if we had an index where technology stocks comprised like a third of the entire index? And you know the saying, when Apple catches a cold, the rest of tech is infected with Ebola. Yeah, that's a saying, really, at least in Silicon Valley. All right, maybe you don't know that saying. Well, it just means that Apple is a really big market cap stock, like knocking on the door of $1 trillion. So it represents a huge percentage of the tech index. So when Apple stock does poorly on a given day, it tends to bring down all the other tech stocks in its wake. Why? Well, because so many investors assume that wherever Apple goes, from an investor sentiment perspective, that's where all the other tech stocks will go as well. Apple buys a gazillion semiconductors and storage devices and stamping facilities, so if its business softens, well, then it's likely that the business of all the others in that tech ecosystem who feed into it, well, they soften as well, because Apple is such a big customer in that space. So, if Apple and tech drop 20% in a given day, and all of tech goes down, like a meaningful amount, and that index is a third tech, well, the rest of the market, banks, transportation, mining, agriculture, etc., well, they might have had just a fine day. Like, they might have been up. But if tech, which is a third of that index, is all down 20% on that one day, well, the overall index would show that, well, the whole market's down an ugly 6%+. And all you would have seen as an investor that the blah, blah, blah 500 index fell from 8,000 to 7,400 today. Well, you might think the world was ending, when in fact it was only the tech world that ended that day, not everything else. Like, banks might have had a great day. Well, who knows? All the rest of the stocks that day might have gone up a little bit, in which case two-thirds of the stocks would have advanced, and yeah, tech, which was a third of them, would have declined. And you'd say that the advanced decline ratio on that day was 2-1. So, if you were savvy, you'd think it really odd to have an advanced decline ratio at 200%, i.e. well above 1, in a market that was down a massive 6% that day. Something would not be adding up in your brain, and you'd know to not just trust the index number you actually heard on the news to reflect what actually happened with market conditions that day, right? So that's why you'd take a very hard look at the advanced decline ratio as kind of a delimiter or truing algorithm in all this.